Now, Botswana's president, Mokgweetsi Masisi, is receiving criticism. His government is accused of arresting journalists and members of the opposition. Some are said to have even fled the country. Botswana National Front's Resego, Kgosidintsiwas, arrested and released a day later. She was arrested on Thursday and released on Friday. We're joined now by Dithapelo Keorapetse from the Umbrella for Democratic Change. Dithapelo Keorapetse, thank you very much for your time here on eNCA. Can you confirm these allegations against the president that journalists and other people who are sort of affiliated to your party are being arrested for no reason?
Yes, I can confirm that. I can confirm that Comrade Resego Kgosidintsiwas was arrested by members of the intelligence services, and she was taken into the custody of the Botswana police, the serious crime squad. Her only crime, it would seem, was to post a Facebook on Facebook that she wishes to mobilize patriots across the country to protest against gender-based violence. Botswana has recently become one of the most violent societies. We have on average 6 rapes a day and about 3 or 4 murders a week, and mostly of women. So she had put up a Facebook post, and then it would seem she was arrested for that. She hasn't been charged, she was released. But it's a trend under the current president. You'd know that a journalist, Daniel Kinosi, ran away. He's now on exile in South Africa. Not so long ago, a journalist, senior journalist of Mokgweetsi Masisi, has had her laptops and cell phones confiscated by the members of the security forces. David Baitsi and Kenneth Mosekimang, journalist of the Weekend Post, were also recently arrested when they were, you know, chasing a story that had to do with the intelligence services. Justice Mutabane, a member of the Patriotic Front, an opposition party here, along with 2 others, were recently arrested and tortured by members of the security forces. So Resego Kgosidintsiwas is among these people who have been arrested by the Masisi government, which is hell-bent on clamping on freedom of expression, including a freedom to hold opinions.
Mm. So, Dr. Keorapetse, I believe that she was released, in fact, on Friday. So have you gotten the chance to speak to her? What is she saying? Is she now facing some sort of court case that's going to continue, or did they release her with no charge?
Well, she was released with no charge after an extensive interrogation and spending a night in a police cell. So we are saying this is harassment. And this harassment, we saw it with our very own leader, Advocate Dumaboko, who was our presidential candidate in the 2019 general elections, which was stolen by the ruling party and Masisi's government with the help of the DIS. He was harassing the leader of the opposition, preventing him to fly across the country and, you know, a campaign. You know that our terrain here is very rough. We needed a helicopter, the aeroplanes to move around. But unfortunately, this was prevented under very frivolous and vexatious, pretext by the Masisi government. Mm. So the harassment of opposition leaders is something that we see under this current president, and we wish to appeal to the international community, SADC, AU, and other pro-democracy forces out there, to appeal to the president, to also assist opposition parties here, too, because we are dealing with a monster in the form of President Masisi.
Mm. I was actually going to ask you, Dr. Keorapetse, this sounds very similar to another neighbor of ours here in South Africa, Zimbabwe. It sounds very similar to what's been happening there with journalists being arrested and citizens also being arrested, or leaders of oppositions being arrested.
Yes, of course, it's similar. Remember that we are currently under the state of emergency in the country. And Parliament has actually been summoned tomorrow to go and rubber stamp President Masisi's decision to extend the state of emergency by a further 6 months. And it's very unreasonable to live under a state of emergency in a democracy. This is a country which has really backslided when it comes to democracy. We have a plethora of laws that restrict freedom of expression, the National Security Act. We have archaic laws such as sedition, criminal defamation in our penal code. We have the Media Practitioners Act, which President Masisi campaigned saying that he was going to repeal this law. When we brought the law for repeal in Parliament, the majority ruling party rejected it in Parliament. We don't have freedom of information law, which President Masisi promised when he was campaigning for 2019 general elections. We have laws such as the declaration of assets and liabilities, which has a clause that criminalizes journalistic activities. If a journalist gets hold of a declaration register and publishes it, they are liable to imprisonment or a fine, a hefty fine. So this is the country that we are living in. We have a parliament that is not independent of the executive. We have a parliament that has more than 40% of its members as executive members. And the effect is that it dilutes whatever decisions, whatever debates that take place in the House. So these are the problems that we have in our country. We have the security forces that are controlled by the president. We have what in South Africa would be Chapter 9 institutions. But here, most of them are not creation of the constitution. They are institutions that are run from right from the office of the president. The public protector, what you call the public protector here, you call it the ombudsman, is in the office of the president. The Auditor General is under the office of the president. The anti-corruption agency is under the office of the president. There's an envisaged human rights institution. It will also be under the office of the president because it will be a subset of the ombudsman office. So you have all these, you have the independent, the so-called independent electoral commission, which is also under the office of the president. So your Chapter 9 institutions in the South African constitution, this side, they are tightly controlled institutions which are controlled right in the office of the president.
All right.
So these are the circumstances under which we live.
All right. I'm so sorry, Ntate Dithapelo Keorapetse. We've run out of time. He is, of course, from the UDC, the official opposition party in Botswana.